My name's Jan Wade and I'm a Community Development Coordinator for Great Places Housing Group. I've worked for Great Places for almost 15 years and for the last 12 years I've worked on the Oldham PFI project. The King's Coronation Afternoon Tea Party was organised by volunteers of the Primrose Centre and funded by Great Places. It was for ladies only and we had around 80 ladies attend. We put on a great afternoon tea with guest speakers, Debbie Abrahams MP, Councillor Elaine Gary, Mayoress, and Najma Khalid from the Chai Project. We also had a craft session which everyone enjoyed and finished with a coronation celebration cake. It was great to see different groups of ladies meeting together and getting to know each other. The Primrose Community Centre was built as part of the Oldham PFI project. It opened in January 2014 and is for not only the local community to use, but for anyone in Oldham. We have a board of trustees and a team of volunteers who help run the centre and organise activities and events. We have a wide variety of activities running at the centre, from education and training, awareness sessions, health and wellbeing, support groups, exercise classes, arts and crafts, and a youth club. We also run a community fridge where we give out food that supermarkets are getting rid of, and we have a free 3-course vegetarian meal every Tuesday evening, which is for anyone. It's so important to have places like the Primrose Centre as a community hub where people can learn new skills, enjoy trying different activities, grow in confidence and make new friends. It's really important to have places like the Primrose Centre.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, are we all ready? And your first ticket, your first one being called is Over Sixes 66. Clickety click, you've been bingo before, haven't you? 5 and 7, 57. 5 and 7, 57. Two fat ladies, 88. Two fat ladies, 88.
Hey, we've got fat men as well, you know.
Well, we'll have fat men next Monday. Oh, I hope not. Pension are kicking off. Hang on, security. Table 5, please. Here we go. See what I can do. 5 and 1, 51. 5 and 1. 51, on its own for number one, on its own for number one. 7 and 4, 74. Anyone close to the
line? Yes, David is.
I hope you're on. Right then, that's bad because she is bad.
It's for a line.
3 and 8, 38.
I want one now.
3 and 8, 38. Still playing for your line?
Shout then.
I can't shout, can I?
Have you got a line?
Have you almost, Leslie?
Line!
Line!
Yeah!
Right, it's easy, isn't it? Just shout out.
You missed it though.
Line! 38.
38. 70. 89. One line press.
Now you can get me a box of chocolate.
I said, chocolate.
2-0. Blind 20.
Two all.
Blind 20. Rishi's Den, number 10. Rishi's Den.
One number.
Number 10. She wants one number. She's on the edge. 2 and 1. 21. 2 and 1. 21. All the sevens. 77. Here. Two there.
I'm checking.
Number three. Good morning, Jack.
today we've put on a party for St George's Day. We've incorporated all the pensioners. We've invited residents from the local care home. So basically, everyone can interact and have a good time.
I don't want the biscuits going to waste. I'm trying to force them.
There's life, as all the people say. You're out of high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that soon. When I'm back on top in June. I say there's life, and it's funny. As if they say, some people get their kicks stomping on a tree. But I don't let it drag me down. This final world is spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, born in a cave. I end up and down and over and he sung above myself, and that's on my face. I hate myself, I forget back, he erases life. Thank you very much.
So we were trying to get people to think about what was it like living on Fitton Hill. Yeah. I mean, what was it like when you were a child living on Fitton Hill?
It was good.
We had fun, didn't we? We always had fun and that.
We were saying before, there's nothing... Back then there was more for the kids
We used to always have adventures and all that. There were always something to do. Yeah. We weren't rich, but some of us were really poor, but we always still had fun. It was a very rough estate. Remember, your dad and all them, it was a very rough estate. Yeah. It was well known, it slowly changed.
But I always said, if I've got the kids in the youth club, we can do whatever we like. There's no reason why we can't take you to the theatre, take you on residentials. Right. And people would go, kids on Fitton Hill don't want to do that. And I'd go, they don't, they won't. Yeah. But you did, and you did. So,
yeah, we did, yeah.
You know, we did some fantastic stuff, I think.
I think
the youth club was a bit like somewhere for any child to go, and they knew that they were wanted. Yeah, yeah. Whether it was mates or whether it was youth workers, they always had someone to talk to. And they always had a good time in the youth club. Yeah. In fact, they used to always go mad when we used to have to close the
youth club. Well, I remember when we closed it, because we used to do Grand National Garden Hopping. You know, we used to do all that. Every time it was closed, we got in bother.
Yeah, we did, didn't we?
We got in bother, didn't we? We got in bother, really. But every time it was closed, I think I was grounded most of the time. I remember my mum, if she knew I was going to the youth club, she seemed a lot less tense. It give her a break.
You know how now, because you've all got children, you know how frightened you are that they're going to get into trouble or something's going to happen to them. So when you did something like the play, I know you can't remember it because you were only young. I mean, do you remember it, Dini or Selena?
I do. I remember bits. I can't remember a lot of it, but I do remember, you know what I mean? I do remember bits of it. More and more's coming back when you see more and more pictures.
Yeah. So, you know, you would get people coming on a Saturday morning to do rehearsal, and you think, that's a lot to ask of people, really.
Especially a young teenager. Yeah, yeah. But they were that committed. Yeah. All of them were. Yeah. I was so proud of all of them.
Well, eventually I was. I'm not going to tell a lie. I was out thinking, right, what can I make for my weekend for the money? And then eventually I got dragged into it. I thought, no, but I actually thought, I like this. Yeah. I like this, you know what I mean? Beats going out trying to ride from coppers and that. You know, it's easy, this. You know, I get a drink, I get a butty.
People to talk to. But the other story, Andy, that I was saying last time we met, that I always remembered was, we've written that part for you about being a lousy kisser. I'm sure you're not.
Wait!
And we said, oh, you've got to go home and learn the part.
Yeah.
And you went, I'm not very happy about that because my reading's not so good.
No, I went, no.
And then you said, I think I'll have to go back to school and do a bit of reading.
Yeah. I think I went back for a couple of days. No, but I regret all that now, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I regret all that now. It's like my daughter now, she's doing a GCSE. Well, she's done a GCSE. Yeah. But
you're clever
you
as well.
You realise, really, you should have done this, you know. Like now, all I do is drive wagons for a living, you know. I do 15 hours a day.
But at least you do something.
Well, yeah. I can always say that I'm appreciating what you did for us, because it was fun. Yeah,
you know, we did loads of stuff with the youth club. We did, like I said, the circus used to come in at one point. I can still to this day juggle with three oranges because of the youth club.
Always
I can't ride a unicycle normal, but I used to be able to.
Yeah, you pushed everybody's limits to see if you could get that little extra bit out of everybody, and you did.
I was remembering that we had a project about taking pictures on the estate. So some of those pictures that are on the programme, I think, were taken by young people from the youth club. So I'd asked this person to come down to do a photographic project, and the person brought lots of really expensive cameras, and I didn't think about it. So I gave everyone a camera.
What did you get? Some of your stuff.
But that's it. I gave everyone a camera and I said, off you go, take some pictures and come back. And as they walked out of the door, I thought, oh my God. It was like 300 quid worth of camera that people had taken. And I'd never said, please don't steal it or anything. It just hadn't occurred to me.
You were very trusting, though.
Yeah.
Very trusting.
And everyone came back.
Yeah, of course. Everyone it was you, that's back. Why. Everybody liked you because of everything that you did for
I got
everybody.
Off at 30 quid for mine. No, but it is a real shame that there's nothing like it now.
Yeah.
It really is a shame.
It's a dentist now, isn't it?
Here, do you think? From here. This was all the youth right here. From here. The building was actually here. That's where the actual youth was.
For me, I don't understand how they can argue that crime's gone up, this has gone up. Oh, you took it away.
You have
some sort of blame. Yeah. I know everything costs money or whatever, but they should reopen them and build them and let their own communities raise money to keep it going.
Hey, my name's Tariq Conway. I've lived in Oldham my whole life since I was born. I grew up on Fitton Hill. When I was a baby, they had a mum's group, and from there they developed a youth centre, and from there on I've volunteered my whole life. Since growing up, I feel like the crime's gone down and it's becoming a lot safer, but the youths have got a lot more dangerous. They're being exposed to a lot more stuff that is not safe for them. I love seeing kids happy and enjoying life. And then we're getting to actually have a childhood rather than dealing with hard stuff. We try and help vulnerable kids to get off the street and just basically just keep a safe place. Do arts, sports, and, well, potentially make a bond for life with someone.